to you when you checked out of your little cabin in South Missouri? Road signs, would say my spiritual director. I was thinking about that this last week when I hung up the phone from a clergy sister of mine. We got to the end of the call, and she said to me, "Could I offer you a benediction?" It was more of a statement than a question. She didn't really give me a chance to respond before she began blessing me over the phone. "Could I give you a benediction?" So all of this was reminding me of a little line in our book by Henry Nouwen. Or maybe Nouwen's line reminded me of all these stories. I'm not sure, chicken or egg, which, you know. But I was thinking about that. Nouwen explains. Nouwen defines the word benediction. We use it a lot. You know, you print it in programs and offer it at the end of things. What does that mean? What does that word mean? Benediction literally means speaking well or saying good things of someone. Now he goes on to explain that a blessing or a benediction is more than a simple word of praise, more than just "good job playing the piano, Jonathan." It's more. It is affirming and saying yes to the other person's belovedness. Over the past several weeks, we've been talking a lot about belovedness, about being beloved of God. And some of you have struggled with that, and some of you have really struggled with that. So I want to go straight to our homework this week. I've been giving homework with each of these sermons, and they all stand independent of one another, so it doesn't matter if this is your first week being here and getting the assignment. This is not algebra. It doesn't build on itself. But this week, for your homework, I want your assignment to be to offer blessings to people as you encounter them in your everyday life. I want you to offer people a benediction. Now, you don't have to hold up your hand like I do and do that, but sometimes it helps. I don't just want you to do it one time. Not just occasionally. I want it to be your intention every day, to think about how you are going to speak words of positive energy and holiness and sacredness and belovedness to actual people that you encounter in your day. Intentionality and sacredness. I want you to really pay attention to the words that come off of your tongue, and especially to the words that you post to your social media. Now, as I've been going through these homework assignments, my hubby educator reminds me, "Now, Shanna, each time you have to be real clear about the instructions, because if they don't understand or they mess it up, then And he helps us with this. In the back of this little book, he has many blessings. M-I-N-I. Remember, we had to learn to the homonyms last week with many, many, many blessings. M-I-N-I. He has one for when you fasten your seatbelt. Wrap me in your love. Buckle me in your blessedness. I wish I could use that one. The blessing, not the seatbelt. That always works. He has these ones on passing a church. Blessed be this house of God and the people who dwell in there. Whenever I read that, I wonder if Ed Hayes ever did that to our place since he lived in our city. Did he pass us ever and offer that blessing for us? He has one on passing an accident. Grant your help to those in need and guard me on my way. He has them for making a telephone call to a loved one or on completing the call, or he has them for all sorts of things. So that we might be a little better at noticing the beloved, the divine goodness all around us. Now some of you are thinking, now exactly how does she think I'm going to do this? Well, I'm going to tell you. For example, you are in the grocery store because you got a text from your people at home that they're in the middle of dinner and they need whatever. So you go to Hy-Vee and you shop at Hy-Vee, and of course it's 10 minutes after 5, which means there's 3 checkers and 400 people, right? You're nodding because you know this. And you're standing in the line, wherever it is you go, maybe you go to Price Chopper. You're standing in line at Price Chopper, and the poor girl who's checking out looks like she's been there for 2 weeks, and she's tired. Maybe she's even a little short with you by the time it gets to your turn. You have 2 options. You can keep your mouth shut, which maybe keeps you from saying something mean or stupid. Or you can stand there and watch her check you out, sack full of groceries, in the reusable bag that you brought, of course. And then as she hands you your receipt, you might say to her, "Bless you, dear one. May you know meaning in your work. May you have rest for your tomorrow. Bless you. May you be. May you have." Now, I know you, and you're sitting there thinking, really? She wants me to say, may you be, may you know. She wants me to bless the checkout lady. That checkout lady is going to think I'm weird. She might think you're weird. She might. She also might think, wow, that was a really thoughtful thing to say. I really needed that. And maybe that helps her get home to her tiny people who've been waiting on her all day. Maybe it helps you pay closer attention to the belovedness of the little gal having who knows what kind of day, checking out groceries. Now my friend Laura Fragan says, because this is, she does this, she taught me the may you be, may you know. The may you be's, may you may be. She says, here's what I do. I'm driving down the road and I see a homeless friend. And she says, I always get sideways with myself. I get so upset I can't help all the homeless friends. And she says, I'm sitting at the stoplight. And I just reach out my hand and say, may you be well. May you be safe. May you be warm. She says, they don't care that. But maybe it resets my own spirit to be in a place more in line with what the divine Receiving that blessing changed him profoundly. Jacob in Genesis, not Jacob of the Steitz. Thank you. When we begin to acknowledge our own belovedness, when we ask for God's blessing on us, it changes us. And it will challenge us to pay attention to that belovedness all around us. May you know. Blessed be. Sometimes it's hard for us to receive those things, to receive those blessings, like it was for me that day of Cindy saying, can I do that right here, right now? Sometimes it feels a little weird. But here's what I'm thinking these days. In a world where it's plenty easy to be negative and critical and be caught up in your own stuff and your own needs and your own wants, maybe a few of us need to be a little more weird. A little more weird in offering a bit of belovedness back out into the world. A little more kindness and goodness. A blessing of love. I need a little bit more of that weird in my life. I don't know about you. The other thing about that Jacob story, you know, he gets his blessing from God. It comes as a price, right? He ends up with a limp. A limp that they talk about even still today. Jacob has a limp. Blessing costs him. Maybe our offering a blessing and being blessed weirdos might be the price we pay. Might be. But I think the world needs a little bit more of it, and I'm willing to do that. Or at least I want to try to be. I want to try to be as brave as Jacob, to wrestle with God, to offer a blessing to all who come before me. Now, you need some practice in this. So this morning, we're going to work on this in a couple of ways so that you don't get to hide me and go, what was I supposed to say? Doesn't matter what you're supposed to say. When we come to the table, I want you to think about a blessing. We think about coming to the table and asking God to bless us. We are blessed with these gifts of bread and cup. But this morning, I want you to literally speak a word of blessing to your neighbor. May you be safe. May you be loved. May you be well. May you be, may you know, blessed be. Whatever it is for you. Now, we successfully navigated this at 8:30, and no one fell over dead, no one was struck by lightning. We all survived and did just fine. You will too. It may be a bit uncomfortable. It may make you feel a little weird. An encounter with the divine will do that. May it be so. Blessed be.